The ASV mode of ventilation is actually, it's been around for the past 10 years. Personally, I started using it about 2 or 3 years ago when I joined this institution. Before that, I wasn't familiar with it, and I've become a believer.
We started using ASV within the first week of our use of the ventilators, and we found great experiences and ease of use with a majority of our patients.
The ASV mode of ventilation is unique. It's a closed loop circuit. It's a mode of ventilation I can put my patients on from intubation to extubation. And that helps me because I know it's a mode of ventilation that'll adapt to my patients' changing pulmonary hemodynamics and mechanics.
I think the differences between ASV and conventional ventilation modes is that it combines mechanical breaths, spontaneous breathing, and has an underlying level of support. It is adapting to the patient's needs, continually adjusting the pressure needed while maintaining a safe ventilation range, and provides all levels of ventilation regardless of what the patient's needs are.
Critical care in patients change. You know, they change from second to second, minute to minute, hour to hour. And if you have decreased manpower, if you don't have an intensivist in the ICU who can stay there 24 hours a day, you need to have a smart mode of ventilation that will make automatically minor changes by itself.
It is constantly adapting to the patient and providing all levels of ventilation, from a patient just waking up from anesthesia to one that we're actively weaning and making ready to come off the ventilator. It's allowed us to manage a larger number of ventilator patients without impinging on the staff's time.
Our intensivists seem to be less involved in taking care of minute-to-minute decisions from the ventilator. They have more time to take care of other aspects of patient care than they did before. In that respect, it is revolutionizing the way we take care of our patients in our unit.